Hey everybody, welcome back to the Lightside Music Reactions. Today we've got a new artist to the channel, but definitely not a new artist for me. Today we are listening to Reba McEntire. She just dropped a new official music video, and so let's go ahead and check it out. Before we begin, I'll give you a little bit of history about Reba to catch those of you up that aren't familiar with her. She is a famous country music singer and also an actress, and she's very often called the queen of country music. She's got a very powerful voice, as I'm sure we're going to hear in the song that we're getting ready to listen to. But since the 1970s, she's placed over 100 singles on the Billboard Hot Country Songs chart, 25 of which reached the number one spot. So she's very popular, got a lot of hits out there. Probably the most famous one is Fancy, and I absolutely hate that song. I can't stand it, not only lyrically, but also musically. Lyrically, I don't like the message of it at all. The message is a horrible message for a song, but a lot of people really love it for the message. And then also lyrically, there's a lot of lines in it that just don't rhyme, and as a stickler for rhyming lyrics and proper grammar, spelling, that sort of stuff, it just drives me nuts. It makes me grind my teeth when I hear it. And just overall, I think Fancy is a horrible song, and yet it's one of her most popular and one of her most famous. Some of her other songs you might recognize, Is There Life Out There? That's actually a good song. I enjoyed that one. Whoever's in New England, I've heard that one before. That's a good song. The Heart Won't Lie, The Night the Lights Went Out in Georgia. That was one of her earlier hits, and that was a good song. If You See Him, If You See Her, if that's the one I'm thinking of, it's a good song. Let's see. And Does He Love You? See, I don't know which one is which. I've heard one of those songs. It's either Does He Love You or If You See Him, If You See Her. One of those two I've heard, and it's a good song. She's got a ton of hits. But I don't recognize a lot of these song titles that it's listed here online. But she is also an actress in film and on television. She had her own sitcom for 6 seasons. And my wife and I used to sit with my mother-in-law and we'd watch that show. My mother-in-law absolutely loves Reba McEntire. And so we really enjoyed watching that series back in the day when it was on. She's been in a bunch of movies. She got her first film role in movie Tremors, which ended up spawning a bunch of sequels to that. And Tremors was a great movie, and it was really cool to see her in that. And then later on, she was in The Gambler Returns with Kenny Rogers and Burt Reynolds. And the Gambler movies are great if you ever get a chance to watch those. If you're a fan of Westerns, check out The Gambler movies with Kenny Rogers. They're really entertaining, and it seems like back in that era, in the early 90s, they were releasing a bunch of Westerns that had country music singers starring in them, and I loved that. You know, it was just so awesome to watch some of my favorite musicians from country music playing in Westerns, and one of those was The Gambler Returns, The Luck of the Draw, and that was Reba McEntire was one of the main characters in that. She was also in a bunch of other movies. Now, here's something I didn't know about her till just now. I found this out looking up some facts about her online. But in 1996, James Cameron cast her in the role that Kathy Bates ended up doing in the movie Titanic. Because Reba apparently had some other prior engagements, prior commitments that she'd made. And so she had to turn down the role. But originally, the role that Kathy Bates had in the movie, that was meant for Reba McEntire. But anyway, she went on to be in the movie Maverick. Let's see, who was the main character in that? James Garner, I think? Or was he? No, James Garner was in the TV series. But they had, was it Mel Gibson? Kevin Costner? I'm not sure. But anyway, the movie Maverick in 1994, she played in that as well. She did some voice acting for some Disney movies. She had a recurring role on Young Sheldon, and I remember from that, did a fantastic job. And let's see, she's been on, she's even acted on Broadway. So, stellar record a lot of hits in music and in acting. But anyway, she dropped this new video this week called I Can't. And it's a new song. I haven't heard the song before. And she just released the music video. So we're going to go ahead and check it out right now. Once again, let me reset my dome light here. Hopefully it won't go off while we're doing our reaction. And here we go. This is Reba McEntire singing I Can't. Nice bluesy sound. I got the trouble in my soul. Drowning in tears, my eyes were too proud to cry. I hear you knocking at my door, but I can't open it no more. Cause this heart's half full of rain and rising high. Sometimes all that you can do is just survive. Okay, right off the bat, her voice sounds a little bit different. It's still recognizable. You can tell her, but there's something about her voice now. There's a little bit more tenor in it. It's not as low as it is, but she's got that accent that shines through, and yeah, it sounded good. But her voice is sounding a little bit different in this recording than normal. Little bit of Southern Gospel blues sound. Or not Southern Gospel, old gospel. Okay, fool for love, I get it. Okay. All right. So let's take a look at these lyrics. And it sounds like she's getting ready to move into the more aggressive part of the song. So I'm sure we're going to get to hear the real Reba that we're used to hearing. Kind of a strong feminist type song. Strong woman type of thing, which is why I think the song Fancy is so popular. This one, so far, I like the lyrics. So far, it's got a positive pro-woman message, where Fancy, I think, has a negative message, where the message of the song really ends up putting the woman in a subservient position, and it's disguised as a position of power. It's celebrating the ending to where she is going into a role to where she feels like she's taking control of things, but really it's going to be detrimental to her health, physically, spiritually, emotionally. It's just something that she's embracing, that people are celebrating. And honestly, I don't think it's a good message. I don't think it's a good lifestyle to live. And I don't think it's good for her to move from being forced into that situation into embracing that situation and making it her own. If you want to truly escape from the tyranny of the patriarchy and those that put her in that position as a form of abuse, which in this case was her mother. So it wasn't even the patriarchy. It wasn't a man that did it. It was her own mother that put her in that lifestyle. Instead of embracing it and making it your own, find a way to escape it. Find a way to escape it and find a better life. Okay, so in this song message is a little bit different so far. She's talking about, I got the thunder in my bones and trouble in my soul. So she's singing the blues here in a kind of a modern, updated way. She's drowning in tears. Her eyes were too proud to cry. But now she's letting the emotions come out. And that's a good thing, because it's not good to suppress your emotions. I've talked about this as a pastor in church, and I think I've even mentioned it in these videos on here, where I talked about how sometimes I get emotional on here, and that's okay. You know, you don't want to look like a blubbering fool, especially as a man. It's not very masculine. But at the same time, sometimes it's okay to let your emotions show. And I think it's a bad thing that when we try to bury our emotions deep inside and let them fester and boil and never deal with them. So here she's trying to deal with them. She's letting the emotions out. Her heart's half full of rain and rising high. So that's where those emotions just build up on the inside and need to come out. And like a dam bursting, she's letting those tears flow, let those emotions flow. And even by singing the song, she's letting her emotions out and dealing with that pain. And I think that's a good thing. Sometimes all you can do is just survive. That's true. A lot of times you feel like that. But here is an example of her singing this song, letting those emotions out. She is not just surviving, but she's learning to deal with the things that are holding her down. And that's important for us. If we feel like we're just surviving, you need to find a way to deal with that and escape from it. I can't row you across right now. I'm too busy building a bridge. Okay. Trying to get to the other side and then not just staying on the other side and forgetting you. I'm not forgetting you, but I got to build a bridge to get you across, and not just you, but everybody else that's trapped on the other side. I think that's a powerful message. Is I'm not just going to swim to the other side and leave you on the other side. But I can't work on just saving you, going back and rowing you across. I'm going to build a bridge so that not only can you get across and I get across, but others can get across as well. And I think that's important. Anybody in a position of power, if you've been able to, or in a position of influence, if you've been able to deal with these sort of things and you have the opportunity to share your experiences, to let somebody else follow you across and to benefit from the struggle that you've had and that you've been able to conquer, then that's awesome. That is fantastic. Take advantage of those opportunities. Don't just swim across, or don't just row back in a small boat and help one or two other people cross. Build a bridge so that others can cross that river of pain and suffering as well. I've been a fool for holding on. I've been a fool for being strong. I've been a fool for love, and I'll be a fool again. So the song, obviously, the pain she's dealing with and she's struggling with and trying to overcome is a romantic situation, maybe an abusive relationship. And I've talked about this in church recently, you know, in one of my sermons. I've done it through the years. I've had different messages on this. But it's a very important, you know, as we love and as we forgive even our enemies. You know, we're supposed to forgive our abusers. But at the same time, you know, there's a difference between forgiving and allowing the abuse to continue. Reconciliation is what I was preaching on recently, the whole idea of reconciling with somebody who has abused you or who has hurt you. It's important that reconciliation is our goal, but if that means accepting the abuse and allowing it to continue, then reconciliation is not the answer. We want to be reconciled with them. That is the ultimate goal, but it is contingent upon repentance on the part of the abuser. So if you're in an abusive relationship, you know, for women or for anybody who is in any kind of abusive relationship, children with your parents, children with anybody else, an authority over them, wives with abusive husbands, doesn't matter the situation. If you are in an abusive situation, you want to try to have reconciliation, going through the steps that Jesus taught us as how to reconcile with somebody and to go through the stages of forgiveness. But at the same time, that is not always the end goal. It's the end goal in the beginning, but if it doesn't lead to repentance and the person not being abusive anymore, then sometimes you just have to cut those lines. Don't be a fool for holding on. Sometimes you got to let go. It says, I've been a fool for being strong. You're not a fool for being strong. You know, if you're strong, that's a good thing. And that's my feminist message to you right now. Ladies out there, you need to be strong. But that doesn't mean, as I said regarding the song Fancy, that doesn't mean embracing the abusive lifestyle that you've been forced into. It means finding a way to escape from it. And as in a marriage that's abusive, we want to seek counseling initially and try to ultimately get reconciliation with that abusive partner, get them to change. But if they don't change, then reconciliation is not the end goal ultimately. What you end up doing is letting them go. And that is truly being strong, is when you put the abusive relationship, the abusive lifestyle in the past, and leaving it behind and moving on to victory. I can't build you a flame right now. I can't burn you a flame right now. I'm too busy seeing the light. Okay, she says, I'm good as new, but I can't tell you when, so keep on striking matches until then. So he's striking matches, trying to light a flame, light a flame in her heart and get her passions burning, get her to come back. And she says, I can't burn a flame for you right now. I'm in pain. I am hurt. You've hurt me. And I can't burn you a flame right now. I'm too busy seeing the light. And that's my prayer for all of you out here, whether you're a lady in an abusive relationship with a husband or with a boyfriend, or whether you're a child that's in an abusive relationship with an adult, or with a person, you know, in the workforce that's in an abusive relationship with a coworker or a superior, your boss, or whatever the case may be, any abusive relationship. I pray that get busy seeing the light, that you don't keep building those flames and keep going back. I pray that you do not hold on to that abusive relationship when it's clear that it's going to continue to be abusive. I pray that you be strong, be independent, and choose freedom, choose life, and choose to see the light rather than burning that flame that really is going to burn you out. All right, let's go ahead and get back into this. I'm really liking this song so far. It's the same story as Fancy, but this song seems to me like this is Fancy if she had made wise decisions in the end. Let's see how it ends. Okay, I like this. She's powerhouse, the vocals. This is the Reba vocals that we're used to falling in love with. She's got that powerhouse voice. And now, as she builds up, it started off slow and soft and low. And then she's built up now. You're starting to hear her voice come out. This is her singing chops, showing why she is so powerful of a singer and so popular. And the lyrics. So let go of the anchor, let go of the chain. Don't reach for me and don't call my name. And of course, she's saying this to her abuser. Shake off the past and baby, just swim for the shore. You know, I'm swimming to the other side. If you want to keep swimming for the shore, go right ahead. But I'm not going to jump back into those waters and risk myself because you refuse to stop being abusive. Now, that's a very powerful message. Blow me a kiss and hope for the best. And again, that's what I was talking about. You know, hope for the best. You know, maybe we can be reconciled eventually if you can truly change. You know, the best is still an option. I'm not completely cutting the ties on you. I'm not throwing you out, leaving you out in the river for dead. I'm hoping that you make it across and that you change. But I'm not going to jump back in the river and continue to be abused. Let go of the anchor, let go of the chain, blah, blah, blah. Blow me a kiss and hope for the best. Just keep swimming for the shore. Wish what you will and take what you get. Do what you want, but I can't save you no more. And so many times in these abusive relationships, you've heard the story time and time again. Oh, he's a good man. He's got a good heart. I can change him. And that is just such a toxic relationship to get into, to where in order to have a good relationship with somebody, you have to have the goal of trying to change them. You know, we want to be able to love the people as they are for who they are. And if a person seems to be lovable sometimes, but other times they're abusive to the point to where you have to change them in order to live, in order to survive, And surviving's not, it's not just about survival. You have to live. You have to truly live and not just exist, not just survive. It's not worth living a life just to survive. You have to learn how to live. And if you're in an abusive relationship, you can't do that. You have to find a way to get out of it. So I can't save you no more. In an abusive relationship, you fall in love with somebody and you want to try to save them. And that's admirable. You know, we all, not just as Christians, but just as humans, we want to save the lost. We want to save each other, especially our loved ones. But we can't save those that won't be saved, that choose to remain lost in their own negative behavior and their own addictions. And addictions, God, I pray for those that are suffering from addictions that destroy their lives, because we can't save each other. We can only point each other to the light and hope that they see the light and allow that light, Jesus Christ, to save them. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. And then through him, we become the little lights of the world. You know, he said, I'm going back to heaven. I'm not going to be here anymore. I am the light of the world. And when, like the sun, I'm like the sun. I am the light of the world. But at nighttime, when the sun is hidden behind the earth, how do we see the light? We see the light of Jesus, the sun, reflecting off of the moon and shining onto the earth. So at nighttime, now when the sun is hidden, when Jesus physically isn't here with us, metaphorically, we see the sunlight reflected off of the moon as if it were nighttime. So while Jesus is the sun, he is the light of the world. Now that he's in heaven, not here physically on earth with us, we need to be like the moon, reflecting the sunlight onto the earth so it can see him, even when he's physically not here, being able to see him, but we can still see his light reflecting off of us. And so many of us, we want to do that. We want to save each other. That's admirable. That's what we are called to do. But there comes a point when you have to say, I can't save you. You have to see the light, and you have to let the actual light, the Son of God, Jesus, save you. You have to accept that, and I can't do it for you. And if you're in an abusive relationship where he's dragging you down into those depths of that sea, you got to cut those ties and let him go. If he swims to the other side, fine. That's wonderful. And then you can let the chips fall where they may. And if reconciliation is part of that, then great. If not, then as the Bible says, shake the dust off your shoes and walk away. And I've got a song I wrote about that at some point. I'll talk about that in another video in the future. Not time for it now. But let's get back into the finale of this song. Nice guitar work there. That's sounding a lot like her, except just that little bit of tenor in her voice that's not usually there. Still got good control of her voice. Wish what you will and take what you get. I like that. Very good. I have a feeling this is going to be a hit for her. This is going to be an anthem for abused women out there, and I like that. Like I said, this is Fancy with a happy ending. A lot of people think the song Fancy had a happy ending. I don't. This is the happy ending that I always wanted for Fancy, And I wish Fancy could be singing this song. You know, I'm not going to stay in this abusive lifestyle. I'm going to escape from it. And so, great song. I am glad I got a chance to realize this was coming out and react to it. Anyway, what do you guys think? Go ahead and comment down below. And if you enjoyed this video, hit the like button and comment and subscribe. Turn on the notifications so when you know when we add new videos. And if you go down the description, there will be a link to the original music video. And you can go over and see the music video and how, you know, it was originally intended to be seen and heard. Anyway, thanks for watching. We'll see you guys next time on the Light Side Music Reactions. Bye, everybody.